Hi, I'm Karen, Chair of FIDO Taiwan Regional Engagement Forum, that's FTF. And on behalf of FTF, it's my pleasure to present to you the Taiwan session. Hi, 各位好，我是 FIDO 台湾分会会长张欣凌。今天呢，很高兴有这个机会代表 FTF， 也就是台湾分会，来向各位致意。并且在这个首次的 FIDO APEC Authenticate Summit 当中，由台湾会员提出演说。台湾的 FIDO 的发展呢，不算太早，但是也不是太晚。不过呢，潜力无穷。在今年五月刚成立的台湾分会之后，终于也在这一次的活动当中取得一席之地。所以台湾的场次就由台湾的会员来进行演说。而且我们有来自政府跟企业的讲者来进行演说哦。In the coming four speeches, there are perspectives of government. It's the first ever speech from Financial Control Organization of Taiwan Government. Ms. Brenda Hu will give us the scope of Taiwan Financial FIDO and how it planned and developed in the coming year.Please stay still and take a look at the whole picture from government. And as I mentioned, it's the first time what we've been told. And from me, I will watch very, very carefully and pay attention seriously for sure. And the second one is the case study, the security key of OpenTrend combined with NEC.To share how FIDO works within the enterprises, especially in circulation industry. Moreover, as we know, FDO, FIDO device on board, is the fresh and new specification and will have the standards very soon. PUF Security is trying to secure IoT and FDO using a PUF-based device identity. 也就是说以PUF 的装置 a physically unclonable function 来强化物联网安全以及 FIDO 的装置 The last one is the biometric authentication in payment 支付领域中的生物识别认证 The famous solution provider FIM will give us the global biometric payment outlook and how FIDO works in evaluation field接下来呢，就让我们来听听金融监督管理委员会胡泽华执行秘书、欧生全黄副总以及 NEC 的 Jim， 以及商马科技的 Kent 和飞马科技的 Alex， 如何来让大家知道他们和 FIDO， 他们用 FIDO 分别在金融领域、流通业、物联网以及支付方面的身份识别技术与应用。And welcome again, everyone.Thanks for sharing. 谢谢。